Charlie.
Hey, Richie, darling, how are you?
I'm really missing you, Charlie. I'm looking forward to seeing you.
Yeah, me too, bruv.
Good. Well, go home and don't miss your plane.
Over my dead body.
It was a huge amount of fun, actually, because, again, as you say, it's outside my comfort level a bit, you know, and that's one of the reasons I jumped at the chance of playing it, because I was always the sort of person who went after these people and then put them in prison. I was the good guy. And then to play the bad guy. And somebody said to me the other day, it's the first time I've ever heard you use a four-letter word in a film. I went, it is. It's that amazing, you know. And, of course, in this movie, it's every other word, which is fun for me, yeah.
I really like to hear them squealing before the end.
That sounds like fun. I'll dig my blades out.
Also, the nice thing about it is that the producer, who I think is a bit of a fan, a very nice man called Jonathan Sothko, has referred to me as an icon of cool. I said this to my American wife. I said to her the other day, I said, you do know I'm an icon of cool. And she said, take the rubbish out. And I said, would an icon of cool actually do that, dear? And she said, he would if he knows what's best for him.
Still devilishly handsome. How does it feel to still be a housewife's favourite? Do you still get sort of underwear sent to you in the post and that kind of thing from groupies?
You know this is a myth, don't you? Underwear in the post. This doesn't happen.
Does that not really happen?
No, no, no. People chasing you down the street doesn't happen. It never did. It never did. I mean, it was very nice for a while. I was very, very famous for a while. Not at all famous now. I'm famous for people over 45 or 50 or something like that. You yourself said that you'd seen me as a small child, which you haven't any idea how old that makes me feel, of course, when people say that to me. But those things don't happen. Or if they didn't happen to me, that's for sure.
Mr. Archer, Detective Inspector Taylor, if you interfere in my investigation in any way, I will have you put inside.
EastEnders, I think you'd be a fantastic fit
yes,
for that.
I would pay them to be in EastEnders. No, I wouldn't, but I would think about it, you know?
Has it never come up at all?
Well, I don't think I'm the kind of person they immediately think of for EastEnders, you know. I mean, I always used to play the toff. And this is one of the reasons why I enjoyed this film, was because I'm not playing the toff, I'm playing a hard EastEnder. So if they're watching and they go, God, he'd be good for EastEnders, I'm ready and willing and waiting to be offered a part.
So, what's the score, Richie?